The Georgia heavyweight champion, Mr. USA, Tony Atlas. His opponent entering the ring, the Russian assassin.
And so the Russian assassin and Tony Atlas going up against each other in this match. One fall with a 10-minute time limit. And Les Thornton, of course, the world junior heavyweight champion, still with me.
This should be a real brawl because, you know, I've worked hard with Tony Atlas, and he really is by far the strongest man I've ever come across. I was on the bench press, doing some bench press with him. I'm pretty strong, but this man did 550 with no trouble when I was with him. So that goes left to say, you know, and his wrestling ability is going to be a very formidable opponent. But there again, we've got the magician, who I think by far is one of the best ones around today. As a look, Tony Atlas did a lovely takedown then, went behind the Russians. The Russians coming out the proper way, you know.
They're into that ring robe now, and the referee will be forcing the break on this, and so...
I think Tony's got to keep up this Russian, otherwise this man can turn everything round, and he can beat you at any given time.
Into an inside cradle by Tony Atlas, but the Russian is able to move him out and escape from possible pinning combination. It's interesting to note, Les, that this was a very special challenge. This man, who is unidentified, notified Georgia Championship Wrestling that he specifically wanted a match with Tony Atlas.
Well, all I got to say that this man must obviously know what he's doing because nobody challenges Tony Atlas and gets away with it. He must think he can beat him. He's challenging. He's going to go ahead and he's going to do it. And he's doing a good job of it right now.
Beautiful leapfrog into a flying dropkick by Tony. Comes into a full power slam, and it is a full slam, rather, and it is Atlas back on him again, a front face lock now. Tony Atlas.
I think he's going to make a big mistake if he tries to outpower Tony, because there's nobody in the wrestling game today can do that. He's going to have to start doing something a little bit different than he's doing, otherwise Tony's going to outpower him and out-wrestle him.
Going for a single leg pickup at this point. Atlas keeping that head imprisoned, and of course it is the Russian now trying to get that leg picked up. If he can get a back leg trip out of this as well.
Really should stand up with him. He's got a man with a hand like that. He can't reach to kick his far leg away. If I was in that ring now, I'd count it. I'd stand up and bring him up with me. But as I said, Tony stepped back into the ring, and his assault was happening, and he's got the hold.
They're into those ring ropes now. The referee again calling for the break. Tony now has that one leg trapped in between the ring ropes and the Russian very quickly driving a knee into those quadriceps femoris muscles of Tony Atlas, trying to take away one point of attack, one point of stability.
Obviously, the man knows what he's got to do. He wasn't overpowering him, and he wasn't beating him with wrestling. So he's got to go back to the old roughhouse tactic, which obviously he must be quite good at.
Atlas still into those ropes, and the Russian still pressing his advantage.
I don't know who this Russian is, but this Russian is something that he knows what he's doing, and he's a very mean man. I'd love to know who he is.
Well, I would too, as a matter of fact, because it was rather unusual that the man specified that he would not wrestle anybody else other than Tony Atlas. And now, looks like he's trying to set for a figure four. Yes, couldn't get it that night.
Well, you see, he couldn't beat Tony with his wrestling, and he couldn't beat him with his strength. So pounding him down with the old usual roughhouse tactics, then went for a leg hold. So he's thought about how he's going to do this thing. He's going ahead and doing it.
Well, he's got the figure four. He does not have it clamped in, however. He does not have it cinched down. And
Tony's got too much power to give up, anyway. So, and he's too strong. I think he's going to either outpower him or pull himself to the ropes, which I would, to get out of these circumstances.
Well, they didn't get that figure four locked in properly, and of course that's given Tony Atlas, because once that figure four is locked in, as you well know, once it's locked in, it's over.
Usually when a man gets a figure four, it's a finish. We call it a finish in the game, as you know, and then when it goes for it, I just said, like, it's a submission.
And it is Atlas rolling away from it. Finally, the hold is broken. The Russian did not have it firmly cinched in. Consequently, Atlas was able to break free. However, How much damage has been done to Tony Atlas now?
Well, this Russian knows what he's doing. He's a good wrestler. He's gone after them legs. Even though he's a leader of what he's doing, this is his tactic for the rest to beat Tony Atlas, but he's going to do it.
Russian outside the ring now. Additional punishment on those femoris muscles of Tony Atlas, and Atlas in trouble here.
Well, if he's not careful, he's going to get counted outside the ring, this man. On any case, like, he could have been disqualified for those kind of tactics, what he did.
Well, it appears to me that he is not as interested now at this point in a pinfall as he is in trying to incur some injury to Tony.
He's got one thing on his mind, to beat Tony Atlas. That's what he did. He challenged him, he came here, he said he was going to beat him, and he didn't care how he's going to do it. He's going to go ahead and try and beat him. But right now, Tony's making a... He's got his senses together, making a big comeback, and Tony can throw mean punches, as you can see.
And it is Atlas. Atlas after the mask. Atlas after the mask of this Russian. And...
Tony's got to be careful here. He's going to get himself disqualified if he's not careful. You can't throw that referee around that one.
Unleashing all stops, the Russian still after that leg, and Tony Atlas unleashing everything he's got against the Russian.
Well, now it's just turned into a mud ball. No one cares. Not even referees got anything to do with it now. Tony's just going berserk. This Russian is, he's after the mask, so, you know, it's just a charade now.
It is Tony Atlas now trying desperately to get that mask off. Obviously, at this point in time, he wants to know the identity of this man who has obviously been trying to deliberately injure him. He's got that mask. It's Krenov.
Yeah, would you believe it? That surprised me. That's pretty Smirnoff, and I never would have believed it.
Alexis Smirnoff, and that mask has been removed. And that is most unusual indeed. But Smirnoff is the man who's come in after Tony Atlas and specifically said that he would wrestle nobody else but Tony Atlas, but he called himself the Russian Assassin, and now a Pier 6 slugfest going on. It is all over, and they're going to have to separate them once again. They're going to have to separate them here. And it was obvious here that Smirnoff had more in mind than just trying to win a match. It was obvious here that he had something else in mind, and that was to injure or re-injure if he could.
For one reason, as you say. This Smirnoff only came here for one reason. That's the main Tony. And for me, someone's put him up to do that.
Well, that's an interesting observation. Let me see if I can't get Tony Atlas and talk to him for just a moment. Well, you could hear the comments, we're going to get you, we're going to get you. You can hear him continuing to say, we're going to get you. So obviously, this man, Smirnoff, is part of a some form of conspiracy or another.
Kind of message is. Now here, last week on Anderson, come out here. Somebody ain't got no business in office. I ain't got no business. You ain't gonna do nothing. You ain't gonna do nothing. You had your chance, and you can get another chance. You, Ole Anderson, Harley Race, all y'all get a chance. You thought you were gonna do something to me? Let him go! Let him go!
Okay, now, sir, no, Tony, please, let's not have any more. Don't risk the suspension, Tony. We'll be back. As soon as we get order restored, we'll be right back. We'll be back in just a moment.